We anticipate hearing more from the president on that deadly attack at the synagogue in Pittsburgh over the weekend, obviously claiming the lives of 11 innocent victims. But in the meantime, the president continues to paint a very stark picture of what he feels like is the media's role in the ongoing unrest across the country. Let me take you to Twitter. The president on social media quite often this morning saying this: there is great anger in our country caused in part by inaccurate and even fraudulent reporting of the news. The fake news media, the true enemy of the people, must stop the open and obvious hostility and report the news accurately and fairly. That will do much to put out the flame of anger and outrage, and we will then be able to bring all sides together in peace and harmony. Fake news must end. Now, the president's comments on Twitter coming after he struck a significantly more healing tone over the weekend in the aftermath of the murder of those victims of the Jewish faith in Pittsburgh, something his senior advisor, Kellyanne Conway, said this morning shouldn't be overlooked.
It's very solemn. I think what's most important is what the president has done. He denounced anti-Semitism in all forms. He said we must rise above this evil. He's called for the death penalty for this murderer in Pittsburgh who gunned down 11 innocent people because of their faith. This president is asking us to rise above it and asking us to come together and unify as a nation. And anybody who's saying he isn't listening.
A quick look at the social media footprint of the alleged shooter demonstrated that he obviously had a great deal of difference of opinion about this president, noting that he felt like the president was siding with Israel on a number of different geopolitical issues. Again, we expect to hear something more from the president as soon as we get it. We'll pass it along, but for now, back to you.